Hello, it's Mr. Ryder with another episode for ClayQuote.com, Bits and Pieces. And you're probably wondering to yourself now, oi, Mr. Ryder, why are you talking with that funny voice? Because that's not how you normally talk, mate. And, you know, you're absolutely right. But we're talking today about race, and I wanted to illustrate that point with things that stand out in your mind a little bit different than you might otherwise take to mean. Because you see, you're used to one thing. In your brain, it's a certain way. And race is a lot like that. We've been so conditioned over the years to think of color as a separation point of humanity, which is really kind of stupid if you think about it. Tracing back everybody's roots, we all converge into a single point that actually originated in Africa. And we are all of a dark-skinned origin. And so, technically, to sit down and actually differentiate race is a little bit absurd, because what we're doing is we're imposing a superiority and issuing a standard that one is better than the other. It's very difficult to break that habit, but it is breakable. And I'll give you a very quick example. How many people ever do you hear refer to Denzel Washington as that black actor, Denzel Washington? I know I sure don't. Denzel's a great actor, and when I see Denzel on the screen, I say, hey, that's Denzel, and there isn't one iota of my brain that says, hey, there's Denzel, and he's black. It isn't a problem about one race, because I can tell you there are stupid people in pretty much every race on this planet. I'll share with you a story when I went to become a teacher, and I had to take some classes, and one of the classes was Diversity in the 21st Century was the name of the class. What I didn't like was the message that was being taught. He would come into class and he would say, we can never forget the injustice that we've done and put upon African Americans in this country through slavery and oppression and just the struggle for civil rights all the way on up. And he must always have this label. And I said to him, I disagree, because I think that every time we put a label on something, whether it's Caucasian American, African American, Asian American, or just plain stupid American, we actually put up a wall that separates people. And the day that we don't have those divisions, the day that we don't think about it, much like I do not consider Denzel an African American actor, he's an actor. That's the day when we don't have a race problem. Because the race problem begins with ourselves. The second story that I want to tell you, an early teaching interview, a group of 12 teachers, parents, special educators at this one school, it was for a first grade position, which I didn't want, but asked me one question. They said, how do you deal with race in your classroom? And I pondered this for a moment, and I looked at them and I said, I don't, because there isn't a race issue in my classroom. And here's what I said. I said, you go to any kindergarten or first grade classroom, second grade classroom even, you do not hear any kid going, hey, I'm going to go play with my African American friend Charlie right now. Or I'm going to go out in the playground today and I'm playing with my Asian American friend Johnny, but I'm not going to play with my African American friend Charlie. You hear, I'm playing with my friend Johnny and I'm playing with my friend Charlie, and that is the way it should be. You see, the problem isn't at that level. The problem is at home. The problem is parents with prejudices and mindsets that like to put the labels and the barriers up. And I know this is an oversimplification, but the bottom line is, like anything else in our life, what we choose to believe becomes the reality, and when it becomes the reality, it becomes the standard. Therefore, the only race that we should be engaged in is to be the best that we can be. Well, I'd like to thank Terry for giving me that suggestion for talking about race today. If you've got a question or a comment you'd like to send my way, you may do so at mrryder@claycore.com. Otherwise, I'll see you next time.